Hi, my name is Adam Peden, and I'm going to tell you guys something about nitrogen buildup and nitrogen in general. Well, I would like to demonstrate to you how nitrogen buildup happens, but all I have right now is the turtle, and this is not a very deep cage, so nitrogen buildup would never happen with something like this, with a little turtle, so I want to put her back. Now, to show you about how nitrogen buildup happens and everything, I think I'm going to need a place with a little bit more water. Now this. Is more like it. Things about nitrogen that you might not know is that they're found in scuba tanks. There's a good amount percent in scuba tanks of nitrogen. It's about 28% in normal tank. Maybe a little bit less or a little bit more in a nitrox tank. The reason I brought you guys here is because, well, to show teach you about nitrogen buildup, and this is probably the best place to teach you about it. Nitrogen buildup, also called bends or decompression sickness, is when you dive down, you dive down too deep, and then you come up too quick. And it doesn't sound like a bad thing to do. You know, you've heard of free divers swimming down to pretty deep depths, and that's all fine and everything. So when you're on a scuba tank, that nitrogen buildup really happens, because scuba tanks have nitrogen in them. So while down there, you're being given nitrogen. While when you're free diving, you start out with the same amount of nitrogen, you dive down, and generally you come up with the same amount of nitrogen as before. So how does this happen? Dive down to, let's say, it starts at about 60 feet. The more you stay down, the more nitrogen you build up. And the thing about pressure is that it pushes in. So it's more compressed in a single area, as you'll see with my demonstration. Hi, I'm Adam Peden, and I'm going to show you how and why decompression sickness happens. So decompression sickness is basically just nitrogen buildup. And why would it happen underwater instead of on land? Because the nitrogen is compressed into a single area around your body. So I'm going to demonstrate that to you with this plastic bag and the pool. Alright, so I guess I'll just have to dive in and show you. So now, what just happened? Let's reverse and take a look. Look at the size of that plastic bag, and compare it to this plastic bag. You can see it's a lot smaller than the first one. So it's the same thing with the nitrogen bubbles. Just think of them as little bubbles in your bloodstream. The nitrogen bubbles build up, so you have, let's say, a good cluster of them in your joint. And as you come up, they have nowhere to go if you don't stop to breathe them out. So you come up, and as the air in them expands, as they start to expand, there's not any way for them to let out, so they get out of your bloodstream and they cause you extreme pain. You have to worry about this if you're in deep water, because that's where you get the most pressure to come in, which is why a lot of times you'll see fish, when they come up, they're already dead, and that's because of nitrogen buildup. But little fish, crabs, diving birds, free divers, you don't have to worry about nitrogen buildup. And that's just because they're not in deep enough water.